as I wander out under the sky, how Jesus the Savior did come for to die for poor, ornery people like you and like I wonder as I wander out under the sky. When Mary birthed Jesus, 'twas in a cow stall with wise men and shepherds and all, but hide from God's heaven a star's light did fall, and the promise of ages it then did recall. Jesus had wanted for any day a star in the sky or a bird on the wing, or all of God's angels in heaven for to sing, he was the
back when I was, I guess, a teenager, early teenager, sometimes on Fridays, my uncle would say, "I'll meet you at the end of the road." And I knew exactly what he meant. I would get my bicycle, and I would ride my bicycle from Craigsville to Cowan, West Virginia. That was 10 miles. And it was a hard ride. There was a hill at Camden-on-Golly. I always had to get off the bicycle and push it up the hill. The bicycle ride took me maybe 2.5 hours, and I would get to his place of work. He worked at Boise Cascade in Cowan, and I would sit at the end of the road on my bicycle and wait till he got off of work. He had a yellow truck, and I would see him driving down the exit of the factory, and he would stop, and I would throw my bicycle in, and I would get in the front seat with him. And we would take off. It was 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We'd take off, and we'd go fishing. We would start out at Williams River, and we'd fish special holes at Williams River. Then we would ride. We would ride to the Cranberry River, and we fished certain holes at the Cranberry River. And then we would ride to the Cherry River, and we would fish certain holes at the Cherry River. We made a complete loop, and where the Cherry River emptied into the Golly River, Curtain Mountain, we'd drive up Curtain Mountain to the exit, to the Crupperneck exit, and we'd go to my grandmother's house, and I would stay the night. I still remember that. I still remember him telling me, "I'll meet you at the end of the road. I'll meet you at the end of the road." When I was a pastor in Nicholas County, the first appointment in West Virginia, I met a very interesting person. His name was Frank Young, and he was paralyzed from the waist down. He was an engineer on the West Virginia Highway Department, And I would go and meet Frank, and we would go fishing. Me and Frank would go fishing. And he had this special vehicle that he could drive. And after we got to the fishing place, which was Grassy Branch Fishing Club, he was a member of that. I remember Frank, I would have to get him out of the car. And I would get his wheelchair, and I would roll over to the fishing hole, and he'd say, "No, that's not the right place. Move it over a little bit. No, that's not right. Move it back a little bit." I moved it for half an hour, and eventually he said, "That's right." And I would go to his vehicle, and he'd put his arms around my neck, and I would carry him to his wheelchair. And we would spend all afternoon fishing and talking. He loved to build highways. He was an engineer on the highways. He was involved with the West Virginia Turnpike. And I remember he told me this. He said, "Pastor, you can figure $1 million a mile." That was 40 years ago. He said, "You can figure that a highway costs $1 million a mile." And he was involved in the West Virginia Turnpike. Everybody knows about the West Virginia Turnpike. It was started in 1947. It was completed in 1988. 40 years it took to build that thing. I remember traveling on that turnpike in the 70s and 80s, and it was the most dangerous highway in the country. You'd be driving down, it'd be two lanes, and all of a sudden it would change to three lanes and four lanes and back to two lanes. So many accidents on that highway that it was just very, very dangerous. I would not drive on that highway at night. But eventually in 1988, they finished that turnpike. If you go from Bluefield to Charleston, you travel the West Virginia Turnpike. It took all kinds of money and all kinds of effort. Mountains had to be lowered, valleys had to be filled up, but eventually it became a safe road. And if you're going to Charleston from Bluefield, there's really no other way than the West Virginia Turnpike. That highway is completed now. It's completed. You know, I think at some point, God looked down upon the people of the world and he said, "They're never going to make it. They are never going to make it home. They need a way." In essence, they need a road to follow. And God sent his Son to provide the way. It all began in a little village, a poor village in Nazareth. And Mary, a young virgin, in a dream, in a vision, told that she would bear a son, and he would be the Son of the Most High. He would be the Son of God. The road begins, and it goes to Bethlehem, a winding road to Bethlehem, and in a cradle, the Savior is born. 8 days later, Joseph and Mary takes Jesus to the temple, to be dedicated to God according to the law of Moses. Simeon, an old priest, is there, and he lifts Jesus up and he dedicates Jesus to God, and he says, "Now, Lord, you can take me, for I have seen my salvation." And in a dream, Joseph is told to take the child and flee into Egypt. And the road continues, and they are in Egypt for a number of years. And then we see Jesus in his 30s. We see him walk out the Jordan River, and John baptizes Jesus, and the road continues. Jesus is led by the Spirit into the wilderness. Into the wilderness. And there he is tempted and tested for 40 days. Everything, every temptation that you experience, Jesus experienced. And he did not fall to the temptation. He did not fall. Then he begins his ministry. Just three years. He begins a ministry of preaching and teaching and healing. And his voice carried all throughout Israel, and crowds upon crowds gathered to hear him teach and preach. And this was bad for the authorities, for the government, because they thought their power would be taken. And they would raise him up as king. And they plotted. They tried him and they found him guilty. And the road continues. The road continues to Calvary, and Jesus hanging on a cross and dying for each of our sins. He's dead and he's in the grave for 3 days. And then he rises from the dead, and he is seen by many. And he preaches to them, and he tells them what to do, and he gives them instruction, and he leads a group to the Mount of Olives. And he lifts his hands, and he blesses his followers. He says, "Go into all the world, teach, preach, and baptize in my name, and I will be with you always." And the story continues. The road continues. Jesus ascends into the kingdom of God. And he waits for us. He waits for us at the end of the road. Amen.
I wonder as I wonder. Out under the sky, how Jesus the Savior did come for to die. For poor, ornery people like you and like I wonder as I wonder. Out under the sky, when Mary birthed Jesus, 'twas in a cow stall with wise men and farmers and shepherds. But hide from God's heaven, a star's light did fall, and the promise of ages, it then